Tonight's a good night, as tonight I have been given full permission by the boss lady here at Care 11 to tee off. And yes, that pun was intended, because I am looking at you, Golf Digest blogger. Golf Digest, the pages where one can fade into bliss over bunkers and shanks, birdies and eagles, and this week, trip into a hot take from an assistant editor about the state of Minnesota, Prince, and the Minnesota Twins? Yes, and an insult to the written word, Joel Beal, hailing from Ohio, has taken it upon himself to mock Minnesota for only having one thing on our resume, only one thing in the gospel according to Joel that defines us, and that is Prince. The word salad dives in straight away with the evidence that we are nothing more than a birthplace of one man with dun dun dun. The news that the Minnesota Twins will honor Prince's legacy by selling merchandise with nods to him and hold a night in his name. Let's go crazy. Let's get nuts, Golf Digest. You have produced a scoop nut scene since Woodward and Bernstein to reveal how lacking we are in culture, a place that also lays claim to the Nobel-winning writer, music icon Bob Dylan, a place drowning in the utter misfortune of having 11,000 lakes and 90,000 miles of shoreline, a place home to the 2018 Super Bowl, 5 pro sports teams, 19 Fortune 500 companies, and hey, the 2016 Ryder Cup. That one's kinda in your fairway. Oh, and BT Dubs, did you see this headline in the New York Times? Yeah, we owned the Winter Olympic Games too. So here is the thing, Golf Digest blogger man. Had your words been clever, we could have laughed it off. Kind of like the grape salad thing that New York Times botched a couple of years ago. Or that time the Washington Post writer Chris Ingram said Red Lake County was America's worst place to live, only to go there and love it so much he had to freaking move there. But your words, well, they weren't clever. You referred to Prince as a cool dude, and then you wrote, and I quote, "Purple Rain was a thing like 30 years ago." You actually wrote like in a sentence, in a way a 12-year-old writes like in a, like, yearbook. Hey, facts matter. Prince had 5 albums prior to Purple Rain. 3 of them went platinum. 1 of them became one of the best-selling albums of 1983. That was like a year before Purple Rain. Listen, I don't know what side of the fairway you woke up on, Joel, to take this chip shot against the state of Minnesota in a blog about baseball in a golf magazine, but we are a forgiving people. So take the mulligan on this one. Swing again. I might have been harsh. I reached out to Joel and Golf Digest and Condé Nast, which owns Golf Digest, and they all, like most men, ignored me.
I don't ignore you.
Except for you.
I learned a long time ago, don't tick you off.
It was ridiculous and bad writing, and like ridiculous and bad writing. Like, why is it cool to make fun of Minnesota when you live in a small town in Ohio and your magazine is based in New York, and we just had the Ryder Cup and the Super Bowl, like I said, blah, 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 blah.
What do you think when you publish that, though? Like, what do you think you're going to get out of it by ripping an entire state and then a legacy within that state who just passed away? It's like, what are you expecting?
Why are you writing a blog about a baseball team's honoring of a music person in Golf Digest in a city that's not your own?
Yeah, so now what, Golf Digest?
Where's the golf in there?
Now what?
Miffed it.
Right.